Well, San Diego and other parts of California are facing another winter of dry weather and drought-like conditions. It's been 1 month since we've gotten rain in San Diego, and experts say there's been a lack of rain for the past 3 years. The Department of Water Resources says it will have a hard time providing water to public agencies this year. There's no word yet from Governor Jerry Brown on declaring a state of emergency.
Jerry Brown on declaring a state of emergency.
Fox Sports Grill camera on the Hilton Bayfront downtown shows a very pretty picture. I mean, it really is. You know, it's gorgeous. It looks really nice. We need some rain. We were just talking about, Shelly was just talking about it. We're not going to get any. We're definitely in a drought. The red flag warning makes it even worse in the inland valleys and the mountains until tomorrow night, for relative humidity levels less than 10%. With high winds, you have that elevated fire danger. So that's what the red flag warning means when the National Weather Service issues that advisory. The high wind warning means it's happening now. You got high winds, and you're going to have high winds. They're going to peak today and tomorrow, start to die down Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, although we'll still be offshore for the rest of the week and into the weekend. No rain in sight. We will have a few high clouds that will move overhead this weekend. I know, this is pretty severe. This is extreme. This is our rainy season. Usually this is when we get some rain. Last week when I was at that meteorology conference, I don't want to hear, I've been talking about it because I love it. It's my favorite professional development thing that I do all year. We were talking about basically, long story short, atmospheric rivers, the Pineapple Express. So while we're looking at the medium and long range models, and it doesn't look like any kind of cyclonic action in Southern California is in the forecast for weeks, there's always the possibility as we transition into February, getting into the end of February, of that just river of moisture that comes in the atmosphere from the tropics called the Pineapple Express. A lot of times the Pacific Northwest gets it, but sometimes it comes into Southern California. If that's the case, we could make up a whole year's worth of rain in 3 to 5 days. So that's kind of our hope. You know, maybe we'll see that toward the end of February. And in the meantime, we're going to enjoy pretty weather to look at. Very, very dry weather, warm, above average temperatures, well below average dew point temperatures, humidity levels quite low. High pressure dominates. You get the compression, the heating, the drying out of it. You get accelerated winds, especially overnight into the early morning hours with the cooling air mass. It sinks. It's just one of the more simple principles in meteorology, physics. The colder air sinks and the warm air rises. So you get acceleration of the air mass overnight when things cool down. So the winds, we're talking about the possibility of 55 mile per hour wind gusts in the inland valleys today. 65 mile per hour gusts getting into the canyons and passes. Warmer, drier weather. The forecast modeling is not showing much of any change as we transition today and tomorrow. We're going to warm up just a little bit today and into tomorrow. Well above average. Yesterday at Lindbergh, our high temperature was 14 degrees above average for this time of year. Inland, you were 12 degrees above average. Today, you're going to be in the low 80s at the beach. Tomorrow, mid 80s. Thursday, you cool down to the upper 70s. Typically, we're in about the mid to low 60s, both at the beach and into the inland valleys this time of year, but not today. Today, you will be in the 80 degree range inland and low 80s on Wednesday, Thursday. Starting to cool back down into the 70s into the weekend. No rain in sight. We will have a few high clouds that will move overhead this weekend. I know, this is pretty severe. This is extreme.